Today I want to provide an update on our response to the China virus. The median age of those who succumb to the China virus is 78 years old. Roughly half of all deaths have been individuals in nursing homes or long-term care. In one study, 90% of those hospitalized had underlying medical conditions, whether it's heart or diabetes, but usually it's some kind of a condition. It seems that people have that, and if they do, it's a problem, no question about it. Young adults may often have mild or even no symptoms. They won't even know they're sick. They won't have any idea that they have a virus. They won't have any idea at all. America's youth will act responsibly, and we're asking everybody that when you are not able to socially distance, wear a mask, get a mask. Whether you like the mask or not, they have an impact, they'll have an effect, and we need everything we can get. Data shows children have the lowest fatality risk. 99.96% of all virus fatalities are in adults. Think of that. So that's much, much, much less than 1% for children, young people. By understanding these risk profiles and learning how to treat the disease, we've been able to greatly reduce mortality in the United States. In fact, we'll show you a chart and how well we do compared to the rest of the world. We have several treatments already available that significantly reduce the severity and duration of the disease, including remdesivir, which has been very successful, and a widely available steroid treatment. And we have many more happening and coming out. We've learned best practices for treatment of the virus at every stage and have shared these findings with medical providers, and we've shared them all over the world. The relationship with other countries has been very strong. We're all working together. This includes ensuring all hospitals are aware of the importance of different approaches to oxygen treatment, including high-flow oxygen, the importance of steroid treatment for those on ventilators. And when you're on a ventilator, we've learned a tremendous about the use of the ventilator. And at the beginning, people never had an experience like this, where we needed so many ventilators so fast, and even the use of the ventilators. But the doctors have become incredibly, and nurses and helpers have become incredibly good at the use of a ventilator, which is actually a very complicated procedure. As cases and fatalities rise in certain hard-hit states, which you're looking at right now, we're surging personnel, supplies, and therapeutics. We, again, have tremendous amounts of supplies. We are in very good shape, and we can move them quickly. Our case fatality rate has continued to decline and is lower than the European Union and almost everywhere else in the world. If you watch American television, you'd think that the United States was the only country involved with and suffering from the China virus. But the fact is that many countries are suffering very, very, very badly, and they've been suffering from this virus for a long time. We've done much better than most, and with the fatality rate at a lower rate than most, it's something that we can talk about, but we're working again with them because we're helping a lot of countries that people don't even know about. I get calls all the time asking for help, especially as it pertains to the ventilators. They need help with ventilators. They have to get them. They're very hard to get.
So Republicans and Democrats on Capitol Hill both said that they want to see more money for testing. They want to send billions of dollars to the states so they can do more testing. And you probably saw Mick Mulvaney the other day said that his kids, it took them a week to get test results back. He said this is simply inexcusable, given where we are in the pandemic. Do you think we have a problem with testing in this country right now? Well, and are you in favor of more money for testing?
We've done more testing by far than anybody. Some of the tests, because it is massive volume, it takes longer. Others of the tests, as you know, are very quick. They're 5 minutes and 15-minute tests. And those are, frankly, the ones that I prefer. But we're doing massive numbers, and the numbers are coming down. And as we go, as an example, there are thousands and thousands of kits being made right now, which give you a 15-minute and a 5-minute test. So we'll be able to get those numbers down. Those numbers are similar in other places. They're also doing massive numbers, numbers like nobody thought possible. But those numbers will be coming down. I agree. I think it's a good thing if we can do it.
Are you in favor of more money for testing?
Well, they're going to make a presentation to me tonight and tomorrow on that. And again, we're leading the world. I think the second country at 12 million, we're going to be over 50 million tests. Second country is India with 12 million. Then you have 7 million, 6 million, and 4 million. I think that we are doing tremendous amount of testing. But if the doctors and the professionals feel that even though we're at a level that nobody ever dreamt possible, that they would like to do more, I'm okay with it. Rather than sending your tests in and, you know, it goes through the mail one day, comes back another day, no matter how they send them, it's a day and a day, so that's 2 days already wasted. And then if it spends by the time you get it back, it's 3 or 4 days if they do an efficient job. We're trying to get the testing on site.
Yesterday you said that wearing a mask was an act of patriotism. If that is the case, why don't you do it more frequently?
Well, I do actually do it when I need. I mean, I carry the mask when I have to go. I went into Walter Reed Hospital the other day. I have the mask right here. I carry it, and I will use it gladly. No problem with it. And I've said that. And I say, if you can, use the mask. When you can, use the mask. If you're close to each other, if you're in a group, I would put it on when I'm in a group. If I'm in an elevator and there are other people with me, including like security people, it's not their fault. They have to be in the elevator. I want to protect them also. I put on a mask. I have no problem with the masks. I view it this way. Anything that potentially can help, and that certainly can potentially help, is a good thing. I have no problem. I carry it. I wear it. You saw me wearing it a number of times, and I'll continue. Please.
Thank you, President.
Go ahead, please.
Are you sending mixed messages, though? Yesterday, you tweeted out an image wearing a mask, and then last evening, we saw you not wearing a mask at your hotel.
Well, I don't know the hotel. I was pretty far away from people, but I would say this. I've explained it, I think, very well. If you're close together, I would put on the mask, and if you're not, I would say that if you're, for instance, I'll see, like here, you've been all tested, I've been tested. Oftentimes, I'll be with people that are fully tested, I've been tested. In theory, you don't need the mask. I'm getting used to the mask, and the reason is, think about patriotism. Maybe it is, it helps, it helps. Now, we have experts that have said in the recent past that masks aren't necessarily good to wear, you know that. But now they've changed their mind. If they change their mind, that's good enough for me. So I wear it when appropriate. Please.